2009 Chevy Cobalt SS Turbo. This thing is a beast. It comes with 260 horsepower, 260 pound-feet of torque, and a 5-speed manual transmission. The engine code for this one is LNF, and the top speed is actually rated at 160 miles per hour. It can go 0 to 60 in 5.5 seconds, in the quarter mile in 13.9 seconds at 102.5 miles per hour, and it only weighs just under 3,000 pounds. When this came out in 2008, it actually set a world record for front drive sport compacts with a time of 8 minutes 22 seconds. Its opponent today is a 1997 Mustang Cobra. This thing has 305 horsepower, 300 pound-feet of torque. It has a 4.6 liter dual overhead cam, 4-valve Ford modular V8, that's a mouthful. It'll go 0 to 60 in around 5.5 seconds, and it does the quarter mile in the same exact time as the Cobalt, 13.9 or 14 seconds flat. It has a 5-speed manual transmission made by BorgWarner, which is not very good, but today, it will do its best.
beautiful though.
This should look pretty good too.
See, it really doesn't sound that loud from the inside.
It's not that loud, but I mean, obviously there's nobody out here, it's just us, so.
When you were over there and I was taking that turn, could you still hear it?
A tad bit.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it's not that loud, but it has like that really distinct noise. It just sounds really good.
Yeah, it needs mufflers and an X-pipe.
Oh yeah.
Very badly.
Absolutely.
And then it might be too loud, but that's all right.
Yeah. I can't wait for you to get those bands.
Yeah.
Sound like a beast.
I might weld those MagnaFlow mufflers on myself with a friend.
Okay.
So what do you think of the Mustang?
I have no words for it other than because I told you, bro, I was gonna get that car in 2011 when I graduated.
Wow.
And
what year?
I really wanted it. I really don't remember the year, but the fact that it's an SVT Cobra, like SVT is, that's what you want, right?
Special vehicle team. Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. That's what you want, but
not the greatest by today's standards again.
No,
I'm not sitting here like pumping up the car, but
and the interior
back then it was pretty cool.
Yeah, and just like those little hood scoops on the front of the engine.
Hold on.
No, but I think my favorite part of this car is probably the hood. Because
the hood?
Yeah, the vents that they have on the front. And these are functional, right?
No, they're actually, I don't think they're functional, man. Let me pop
really?
The hood here. I don't think Ford was that good.
I would be surprised if they're not functional.
No, I don't think they are, man. This car, it's not that fast, like it really doesn't need functional aero. Besides the spoiler. Oh, there we go.
Huh.
There she is.
Damn, dude. She's
it's a
clean.
It's a big girl. Well, it's only a 4.6, but
yeah,
looks big.
Holy shit, bro.
Looks big because of the dual overhead cam.
Yeah.
So
it seems like you have a supercharger. It looks like you almost have a supercharger. So.
That's the intake manifold, man.
That's just the manifold. Yeah, this thing's beautiful.
Yep.
Just like
it is the
Cobra end grain on that manifold.
So those are the two guys who actually hand built the engine.
Paul W.
And Dave.
Paul Walker, bro.
Dude, Paul Walker built my Cobra?
Hey, just roll with it.
That's cool, man. Extra 10 horsepower just because of Paul Walker.
This thing's pretty clean too.
It is pretty clean. Engine looks nice. There's no like salt corrosion or anything like that.
Yeah.
It has like a strut brace from the factory.
Okay.
So, it's pretty cool.
Damn, bro, this thing needs to
I can't believe you almost bought one of these. I think I do remember you talking to me briefly about that months and months ago.
Yeah, it was a while back, but yeah, bro, I think you made a really good buy then. I mean, you already fixed the transmission issue, so.
Transmission's fixed, yep.
Damn, man.
So these seats were custom. They were custom done back in 98, I think. He has the receipt for it, so I have the original seat skins, which are leather too. They're black. Mm-hmm. I have those at home.
My uncle had a GT convertible. It had like it was a teal, and I just remember driving that when I was like 8, 9 years. Not me, but driving in the car when I was 8, 9.
Oh yeah.
And yeah, I love these interiors though. Can I sit on this?
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, I remember.
I need to clean that seat.
The long doors.
Yeah.
Oh, dude. Are you already used to like shifting his gear or shifting his car?
Dude, shifting that car, the transmission sucks.
Does it really?
Like, I cannot bang gears.
Oh, I see.
Because it's very sensitive.
Gotcha.
So.
Oh, yeah. This kind of almost feels like my Cobalt. Like, I have to be very careful.
It just feels super loose. So that worries me still is like the transmission, the shifter just feels like a piece of shit.
Mm-hmm.
Even though it sounds like the car was banging gears from first to second.
Yeah.
Because of the tire chirp.
Okay.
It really wasn't. Like, there was no banging.
You were just...
It was granny shifting, for sure.
Yeah. That's pretty cool, man. I like the way, like, the compartments are placed in this car.
Oh, I don't. I think the interior is total shit.
Really?
Yeah.
Nah, man.
That's my opinion.
Yeah.
It would be really cool to get a touchscreen and an Apple CarPlay unit in there. I think that would be a game changer. We'll see how well the subscribers like the Cobra. These videos get enough views, then I'll do more stuff to it. When are you gonna start building the Cobalt, dude?
I'm almost there.
Come
on! I'm almost there, bro.
You made $1 million in the stock market. Come on, dude, take some out and get some stuff done. Easy. There you go. So I just got absolutely smacked by a C7 Corvette, obviously. But he was really cool. We were at the stoplight, and he just started going. So I went too. I think he was probably doing like half throttle, and then I floored it. And then obviously he left me. This sounds so good though, I want you guys to hear it. Good times, guys. So that's it, guys. Those were some pretty good runs. I'm very happy with the way those came out. Again, this video is highly edited, and what you saw is not real. But still, the Cobra did better than I expected. I thought the Cobra was going to get completely smacked. At the top of fourth gear, the Cobalt just has so much top end, it just blasted right by. I think the Cobra needs more airflow for sure. It definitely needs the JLT cold air intake, which is the best one you can get for this car. And it absolutely needs an X-pipe of some sort. I don't know if I'm gonna get a catted or a catless. Probably I should go catted. Very soon, I'm gonna bring the Cobra and Sergio's gonna bring his Z. We're gonna bring him to a dyno shop and see what kind of numbers they put down before I start modifying the Cobra. Going from 327 gears to 373s, I'm not gonna see an increase on my dyno numbers, but you will feel it like on the street. It's hard to explain, and I know that a lot of you are Civic owners and we never really have to mess with that sort of stuff. Although from 2019 to 2020, the SI did get a 6% shorter final drive ratio. So that's basically what I'm gonna be doing to the Cobra. And it's gonna be a lot more than a 6% difference. So the straight line performance will be increased. Every single time I go into fifth gear though, it's just gonna bog down. I mean, fifth gear is so, so big on that car. I think it's rated for 155 miles an hour, something like that. Like going into fifth gear, it would take forever to get there. So I see why a lot of people boost these, either turbo or supercharger. It ends up being quite a complicated thing to do. We'll see what happens, but let me know if you enjoy this video. There's so much content coming this month. If you haven't already, I would definitely recommend hitting the notification bell, because I made a plan of all the videos I'm gonna make this month, and there is so much good stuff. I can't wait for you guys to see it. All right, guys, I'll see you on Tuesday.